This is our land. These are our people. The workers, the strivers, the builders. These are our people. Who are they? They are the dark armies. The dark murdering armies whose only honor is atrocity.
The answer to 1984 is 1776. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
We are live, ladies and gentlemen, now into hour number two. Thank you so much for joining us. We've got wide open phones. We're also simulcasting the video transmission at prisonplanet.tv, not just the radio, blasting out on your AM and FM dial. Let's go through a bunch of your calls right now on the Libya situation, the new loving democratic government banning all protest of any type in Egypt, raping women as punishment, Financial Times of London, Associated Press, low-level radiation found in Massachusetts, including Boston. More low-level radiation from Fukushima in Nevada, also making its way into Western Europe. Let's talk to Timber in Texas. Timber, you're on the air. Welcome.
Hi, Alex. How are you doing?
Good. Welcome.
I just started listening to you at the beginning of the year, and I became a member pretty quickly after I watched your five movies. I have two quick questions. One's considering a note I sent into your office about Ben Bernanke. I found him, he's on the board of directors for the Bank of International Settlements. Since I'm kind of new to this, I don't know exactly what that means with him running our Federal Reserve and then being on a bank for international settlements. I'm kind of confused that he has that dual power, that conflict of interest there. And the second question is concerning Jesse Ventura. I was wondering if his show is going to come back on TruTV this year.
He's not back from Mexico yet. He's going to be on the show in about a week. He gets back from Mexico just here in a few days. He lives down there during the winter. I don't blame him with those Minnesotan winters, 20, 30, 40 degrees sometimes below zero. But last time I talked to Tyrell, his son, who's involved with the show, one of the executive producers, they're not sure yet. There was censorship from Homeland Security. That's been confirmed by Ventura here on air. The police state episode that I appeared in a bunch of them, but that I wrote a lot of and did the research on, upset Homeland Security so bad with their FEMA takeover threat fusion center area that they put pressure on Time Warner, the parent company, on the CEO of TruTV, something you've never experienced, to never re-air that show. And normally they re-air a show more than 50 times because it costs $300,000, $400,000 to make one episode, so they don't get their money back from production costs just airing it once, twice, even three times. They've got to air it quite a bit. And the show did get top ratings on TruTV. That's a big no-no. It did, getting 2 million viewers is big, folks, for a new show on cable. And so we don't know what's going to happen with that. But Jesse, who sued the TSA and a lot more, he will be joining us coming up. What is he scheduled for the 4th of April, Jaron? Yeah, the first day he does interviews. I know he's on this show for a full hour, but I appreciate your call, Timber. Timber, that's a big question, though, your first one. I took your second one, obviously, first. But to answer your question, Timber, you basically covered what the world government is yourself by asking that question. How do we have all of these Federal Reserve officials? How do we have the Treasury Secretary? How do you have these supposed government people on boards of the IMF, the World Bank, the International Bank of Settlements that are openly calling for an end to the dollar, that are openly calling for dollar devaluation, that are openly calling for an IMF World Bank issued Bancor global digital currency that controls the interest rates of every nation on earth and controls the value of your currency? Well, we have a private Federal Reserve. That's how. That took over in 1913. It's private. It controls our currency and credit. It issues its own member banks interest-free loans that they then loan out to everybody else at high interest. They also then create derivatives that they sell into the open market. This tiny inner coterie of bankers, private bankers, have a completely tilted playing field. It'd be like if the Dallas Cowboys were playing the New York Giants and there was a 45-degree angle that they had to play up and that they were basically running up the side of a cliff against the Giants. Would the Cowboys ever win? The answer is no. So to use a sports analogy, it's like having a tilted football field. I mean, it's impossible. And so that's how these guys have taken over the world, set up their own global empire, and now they're just out in the open where the UN tells the president what to do and Congress isn't involved in wars, or where the IMF and World Bank tells the Congress what to do on financial issues. And look, just 2 years ago, Ireland was the apple of the world, the best country in the world, the fastest growing economy. And then the bankers come in and their own head of their own private Federal Reserve in England, in Ireland, same thing happened in England and Iceland and Greece, said, okay, hundreds of billions of dollars the taxpayers must pay to bail out the mega banks. You don't owe it. Doesn't matter. Foreign banks are coming in to buy up the infrastructure. And so that's what the New World Order is. It's private corporations set up the IMF, the World Bank, the World Trade Organization, the UN. Then they get Congress and parliaments of different countries to sign over much of their operating authority into those quasi-governmental institutions, but the profit is privatized. So profit is privatized to the elite, but the loss is made public. And there's a method to that madness. They want a destroyed economy. They want an economy that is being basically shut down. They want an economy where you're in debt. This is a sharecropper economy. You know, many historians report that sharecroppers in many cases were worse off than black slaves because slave owners would at least see the slaves as property and something that they wanted to take care of. But sharecroppers came in and only got a tiny percentage of what they produced, and the laws were written where they basically had to buy all of their products from the company store. You know the song, I Owe My Soul to the Company Store. And so the sharecropper owners never wanted the people who were their sharecroppers to be able to get out of a position of subservience. And so that's all that's happening in the larger economic realms today. The big mega banks make their money out of fraud, make their money out of government power that they've gotten signed over to them, make their money out of actually printing the money and issuing thousands of trillions of dollars in fake derivatives that you will then pay good money into the stock market to own. And they make money on the way up, consolidate power, then they implode the system by design and say, give us unlimited trillions. I mean, just 2 months ago at Davos, headline, all over the news, G20 calls for $100 trillion in additional liquidity to be given to them. Davos, private heads of those groups, public Bilderberg group meeting. Davos calls for $100 trillion of new liquidity, your tax money backing it up, your labor, to give them $100 trillion. Then the private bankers, not your local bank, the big mega banks that are using regulators to shut down your competition, the different local banks and systems, the credit funds that you can join. I'm having one of those moments. Credit unions, they're trying to shut all that down. I'm not saying your local bank's evil. You know, lending is good. We need that. But they aren't the big mega banks, the big mega operators who want to consolidate wealth. Then they take that new $100 trillion they're getting through fractional reserve banking. For every dollar they get, they can loan out 10. But now since the end of Glass-Steagall 12 years ago, it's not even 1-to-10 ratio. They can loan out unlimited. $1 could be a trillion. And then everybody wonders why they're consolidating power. Everybody wonders as the world goes into a depression, J.P. Morgan Chase, Goldman Sachs are making trillions in profits, handing out hundreds of billions a quarter in bonuses. I mean, there's secretaries there. I've seen reports making $5 million a year. That's like their tip. You know, the broker makes $80 billion. Now, here's a tip, honey, $5 million. That's all stolen.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Network.
Look at the shoes you're filling. Look at the blood we're spilling.
Okay, getting right back into the live broadcast and your calls. See, I just spent like 8 minutes on that one caller's question because it was so important. To be technical, I've seen cases in the last 3 years of brokers making $7, $8, $9, $10 billion themselves a year on $100 billion deals that they've put through based on your tax money and derivatives that they've sold. And I've seen the reports of their secretaries getting multi-million dollar bonuses. They're doing great. The rest of us aren't, on average. That's because they're not free market. It's inside baseball. It's a rigged casino. And I've had countless top brokers on to break that down. Here's an example, and it's in my film, The Obama Deception. Henry Paulson, all totaled, got over $500 million of bailout money. But in one particular payment he got, as the Treasury Secretary, he ordered the hundreds and hundreds of billions to be paid in to Goldman Sachs. As the former CEO of Goldman Sachs, he had all those shares in there. And he was paid in one payment over $200 million. And Congressman Stern questioned him on C-SPAN. We have the clip in the film and said, well, how did you get a waiver to give yourself that? And he said, well, I got it from Treasury. Well, he goes, who gave you that waiver? Well, I did. So he gave himself a waiver to get taxpayer money. And lest you think I was joking about the 100 trillion number, there's the London Telegraph. World needs 100 trillion more credit, says World Economic Forum. $100 trillion to them, which they then leverage to the power of infinity against everybody else. See, they're waging war against the real free market. They want you as debtor slaves. Jack, then John, and others. Jack in New York, you're on the air.
Hi, Alex.
Hey.
Hey, thank you for taking my call and for all your hard work.
No need to thank me. Go ahead.
People, you need to start boycotting CFR, major corporate members of Chatham House, big banks, and big corporations. This is of magnificent importance. If we do not start buying local now, we will burn in hell with the Bush family. Now, Alex, I've been doing a massive amount of research in natural preventative herbal medicine, especially concerning radiation poisoning. What do you think about the aluminum and barium salts and the chemtrails reacting with the radioactive fallout from the Fukushima disaster?
You know, that's above my pay grade, Jake. Sorry, calling you Jack. Got another Jack there in line. That's a little above my pay grade, but the government now admits they've had secret atmospheric manipulation, weather modification under patents. Mixing the aluminum dioxide, the barium salts in with jet fuel so the airlines don't even know, and then creating these nuclei that form clouds. And so, indeed, there's a lot of secret stuff going on. I appreciate your call. John in Texas. John, you're on the air.
Hey, Alex. How's it going?
Good.
Alex, why don't the Japanese just pour concrete over that whole thing and stop this whole mess before it gets any worse?
Because they're melting down so bad, sir. They poured it on Chernobyl when it was basically almost done melting down after 10 days. This thing's been in one stage of meltdown or another for 16 days now. And there's a water table right there. There's an aquifer under it. And there's the ocean right there where the Japanese get most of their food and many of their export seafood that they fish. And that they farm out of the ocean. And so they've said that they haven't gone to the Chernobyl scenario yet of trying to cover it up because it might not work and it could actually cause a bigger explosion.
We're in trouble then, right?
Well, the Japanese certainly are. Luckily, there's 4,000 miles of ocean there. But yeah, a lot of the radiation's already gotten here. Thank God it's not that high, if you believe the media. But
Alex, one more quick question. Are you yourself taking the potassium iodide, or will you if it gets
No. I've made it completely clear with medical doctors, scientists on the show. You have it in case there's a reactor meltdown here and it goes above 200 times safe levels, but still consult your physician. That's what I would personally do. And it only protects you from the radioactive iodine that is reportedly hitting the U.S. It's all from coast to coast now, from Boston, Mass. to Southern California. I read those headlines earlier, but a lot of nutritionists and medical doctors we've interviewed have said just normal thyroid help, normal potassium iodide drops, not at the medical level, but just the regular supplement level, still helps you have a healthy thyroid so it won't absorb as much of the radioactive iodine. But no, I'm not taking that yet.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. I appreciate your call. But don't go off what I do. Consult your own physician. We had Dr. Busby on Friday. I had a fill-in host, Paul Watson, sitting in. I still worked Friday. I have so much stuff going on I had to take off just to get a lot of stuff done around here. And I did yesterday actually listen to much of that broadcast. And by the way, Watson did an excellent job. Dr. Busby is a chemical physicist, does advise the British government on radiation poisoning. And he said that in some areas of the U.S., he probably would have children start taking it. But that's what he said. You talk to your own doctor. Let's talk to Dungeon Master. What do you work for? Homeland Security, run one of those black sites, torture sites? Dungeon Master in Texas, you're on the air.
All right, sir, I wanted to talk to you about Homeland Security in my area, now that you mentioned it. They've been inspectioning public transportation buses, and I've seen DHS agents into the buses, checking everything in, and I've seen several DHS agents with bulletproof vests and with canines and going everywhere and like just with their God complexes and looking for a suspicious activity. So, and I know that they're already hyping terrorist attacks and everything, and I don't know how this is connected in my area because I live in Laredo, Texas. So,
All right, let me break it down for you. 8 years ago, almost 9 years ago, Governor Ridge said on C-SPAN, I saw him, that you'll have to have a Homeland Security card to even have a job. Homeland Security, through Viper teams, will have checkpoints on every major street corner. And now in the last 2 years, it comes out in the news here and there, bus stops, train stations, Florida, Miami, Dallas, Texas, L.A., San Francisco. Drudge Report has carried our reports on this, but it's been all over local news. They've had regular Army checkpoints in Tennessee. The governor said they couldn't do it. They said, we'll do whatever we want under Homeland Security. End of 10th Amendment. Why not? We have the UN ordering wars. Congress isn't involved. So this is martial law, but they don't announce martial law. They just start. I saw another drill in the Associated Press. In fact, I forgot to cover that. It was Thursday. Print me the we wrote about it, but AP reported. They'll have drills at schools, mainly elementary, where federally funded local police come in with a script they've got to follow and say, we're homeschoolers against public education. We're going to kill you. And they point guns at 5-6-year-olds. They soil themselves. This is in the news. First started happening in Michigan. But in this new case, they announced that they were anti-open border groups. So it's meant to make the parents and their weak minds, they've been trained not to get mad at the government, they only get mad at the group they're told that the drill was for. So pro-gun groups, pro-homeschool groups, anti-open border groups. They had the police come in unannounced, terrorize the children. This was in the news last Thursday. Terrorize the children. Headline, school drill, terrorists were anti-immigrant group. I think that's the headline. And there's been cases in Minnesota where lawsuits have been won. They had a big case with a big pharmacy. Last year, where the insurance company mandated that they do an unannounced robbery, and it freaked all the pharmacists out, and they rightfully sued. We were getting our house reinsured. We've moved, and the lady came out and asked about our dogs, our kids, any domestic help, firearms. And my wife just said, we're not getting insurance with you. Get out of here. And the lady was like, well, it's Homeland Security. I've got to ask these questions. They're turning everybody into spies. There's the headline. School shooting exercise portrays students as anti-legal immigration terrorist.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
You are obsolete, Mr. Wordsworth.
A lie. No man is obsolete.
You have no function, Mr. Wordsworth. You're an anachronism, like a ghost from another time.
I am nothing more than a reminder to you that you cannot destroy truth by burning pages.
You're a bug, Mr. Wordsworth, a crawling insect, an ugly, misformed little creature who has no purpose here, no meaning.
I am a human being.
Words, Mr. Wordsworth, that have no substance and no dimension, like air, like the wind.
I don't care. I tell you, I don't care. I'm a human being. I exist. And if I speak one thought aloud, that thought lives, even after I'm shoveled into my grave.
Delusion,
illusions, Mr. Wordsworth. Delusions that you inject into your veins to make you think you have a strength when you have no strength at all. You have nothing but spindly limbs and a dream, and mistake has no use for your kind.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
Hillary Clinton on ABC News today was talking about Libyan dictator and how he's a tyrant. Well, he does fit the bill of a tyrant compared to this globalist crime syndicate of non-free market megabanks running around financing laws worldwide to destroy liberty, putting dictators in. If he's a tyrant, he's a little one-inch tall tyrant compared to a thousand-foot tyrant that is the New World Order. But going back to what that caller raised, yes, suddenly Homeland Security's running checkpoints and training police to run checkpoints and funding grants for checkpoints and having the Army run checkpoints. I saw a report almost a year ago, Fox News, upstate New York. Over 2,000 arrests for drugs and firearms in the middle of the state. And it showed families driving under high-powered X-ray machines and the National Guard standing around with Homeland Security being radiated themselves. Not just no Fourth Amendment, but the military doing it. And they're just acclimating us, getting us accustomed to it, breaking our will. But they're not going to call it martial law. They call it security. Now, they did call it martial law 2 weeks ago in Michigan when they started saying they can seize people's bank accounts and do whatever they want. They called it financial martial law. There's been a lot of city leaders in places like Milwaukee 2 years ago that said we need martial law. Sometimes you hear it, but mainly it's a shift from a free republic on the spectrum towards tyranny. And we are sliding into what is classical martial law. Now, I want to get to John and James and Elliot and Keith and Brooke and Richard and Francis and Johnny and Blue. I'll try to get to all of you. But I wanted to hit on something, and I won't have a lot of time to get into this because I want to get to your calls. But here is the headline. U.S. military launches spy operation using fake online identities. And it goes in, this is out of the Huffington Post, also of ABC News, with these robots, these computerized robot systems that can pose as millions of people to put out domestic messages on social networks and to make it appear that people accept what the Pentagon's doing. And it's also come out the Pentagon launches psyops on members of Congress. And the Pentagon has been caught spying on Ron Paul. That was reported on a few months ago. In fact, folks won't believe it. Put the headline into the search engine. Homeland Security spied on Ron Paul. And then when you read deeper into it, it admits it was the Pentagon. I mean, that's our elected government. But see, now the Pentagon follows UN orders, so they better spy on the guy that points that out. They better spy on the real government. They better spy on the Congress. Here's some more of those headlines. This is out of Wired. Military report, secretly recruit or hire bloggers. Now, I've noticed something on Infowars.com with IP addresses, and I've noticed it in the comments. I've noticed it on our YouTube channels, over 300 million views, one channel, 95 million. I've noticed it, and I noticed Cass Sunstein said a few years ago in the White House, he said, we'll infiltrate, we'll pose as conspiracy theorists, because they've got all the credibility now. He used that term. That's anybody that questions the government. It's called a conspiracy theorist. And we'll put out ridiculous info and we'll attack other people from within, like the 1960s, 70s COINTELPRO. So that's what they do. They attack the real people like Ron Paul, myself, and others, and they've been caught doing it. And they have George Soros outfits, Media Matters, Huffington Post, all of them, constantly, every day. They had three articles out this weekend attacking me on Media Matters, putting out basically disinfo. Here's another one. Israel recruits army of bloggers to troll anti-war protest. Here's another one. Dr. Cass Sunstein wants to turn off the lights of the free press. He said arrest people that don't agree with man-made global warming. A Center for Media and Democracy, fake TV news, widespread and undisclosed. So all of this is going on. And a lot of times, and I love it because it just adds to the debate and educates people, I'll see a particularly viral video that we've put out, and I'll see people come in and post disinfo. And then I'll go to their pages and notice that it's basically the same stuff posted on every YouTube channel they've got. And it's a handful of people roboting and just saying the same thing over and over again. And it's always going after weak-mindedness. It's always, everybody knows Alex is bad. Everybody knows Alex is exposed. Yeah, everybody knows our listenership, readership exploding off the charts, credibility rising. So much of what we've talked about has come true with precision. You know, cover of Talkers Magazine, keynote speaker this year. It's usually Limbaugh or Sean Hannity. Top ratings on stations we're on across the country. New York Times doing profiles. Rolling Stone. New York Magazine set to front page thing tomorrow. You know, just huge effect. Exponential growth. But it's like rumors of my demise have been greatly exaggerated, as Mark Twain said. Well, in the beginning, a patriot is a scarce man, hated and feared and scorned. But in time, when his cause succeeds, the timid join him, because then it costs nothing to be a patriot. But to see how desperate they are, to see and to know their, and to see the IP addresses that they don't even hide that it's government on the comments, to see that they try to get weak-minded people to kind of follow in a snowball, and to see how they always use disinfo targeting weak-minded people. And here's an example. I shot a video Friday because I am the voice of the end of America, because they asked me to do it, and I agree with their newsletters, and they're talking about QE3, dollar devaluation, Federal Reserve. You know, I mean, even the Wall Street Journal says what great predictions they've made. Barron's, you name it. I mean, this is a top-flight group. And yes, I have sponsors. That's a dirty secret that I have sponsors. It's a sponsor. He's hiding it. You hear the radio ads everywhere. And the head of marketing came down here to visit me Thursday. So I cut a video about it Friday, and he showed me the emails. But, of course, they're confidential. So he said I could mention them, but I couldn't show them on air. But the point is, it's banned from Fox, the commercial that I'm the voice of. It's banned from ABC, NBC. They just refused to even take the ad. That is an ad sending you to a free video that then sells a newsletter at the end about dollar devaluation, how to protect yourself. So I shoot a video saying, I'm the voice of an ad, it's commercial, and it's been censored off all these TV networks. Then they go with the disinfo. They say, Alex is lying. I saw that ad air last week. Well, yeah, on one of the satellite networks, they get half the ads or part of them. They are still inserting them. But on Fox Network itself, they're not. See, but they know the public doesn't know how advertising works. So they play on that ignorance and say, Alex is lying. It's still airing. Even though the video, I say where it's airing and where it's been banned very clearly. And then no one even bought it. All the others are the same fake people. You can go look at their channels. You can see what they're copying and pasting. But it's so incredible, and it's kind of spooky to be engaged by these people. And then they go into another lie. They say, this is a camouflaged ad. It's not a camouflaged ad. It's about how the ad's been banned. And of course it's meant to get you to go see the banned ad that points you at the free video. The whole point is they're not letting it go on air most places. They're refusing it. Just like they refuse Russia Today ads. Just like they refuse Ron Paul ads before. Just like they it's a point, even if you don't agree with the information, it's about the censorship. But they create those straw men. Let's go ahead and play this video where I break it down. Then I play the banned TV ad. Oh, we're going to break? Okay, we're going to come back and play that. Man, this show just goes by. I might have to go into overdrive here because I've got to get to this and I got to get to your phone calls here. Now, there is just so much to cover, but it's just amazing to see how they prey on the dumbest people. But see, that won't work because the people are waking up and thinking, and they learn how to see the disinfo. And so all the globalists have is dumb people who can't tie their shoelaces.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Crashing through the lies and disinformation, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
So the system is discredited. It tries to get us to stay within the left-right paradigm and fight with each other when the globalists own both wings of this system. And you know about seminar callers. Rush Limbaugh exposed those decades ago. That's a Democratic arm. But it's not just the Democrats that have that. The Republicans have it, and corporations have it, and the Pentagon has it. And that's my whole point, is this is going on, and we are the ongoing target of it 24/7. and it's intensifying, and it's on record that it's going on because they want us to all infight with each other. Imagine a TV ad sending you to a video, so you learn about dollar devaluation, you learn about Goldman Sachs, the Federal Reserve, you get a newsletter so they can finance the whole thing, and they make it like that's dirty. Oh my gosh, this ad's too scary, even though it's admittedly going on, you can't air it. And then they put out this info that we said it won't air anywhere. No, it's been banned. It went on some networks, I'm about to list them, and then they got pressure and pulled it. I've seen Jesse Ventura's show through Homeland Security, at least one episode deep sixed. We're experiencing censorship, but that isn't the issue. The issue, how is I'm bad because it's an advertisement. That's the whole point, that in America you can't make an ad and go buy time on TV, or even if it gets on TV, the system gets scared and puts pressure on it, and the guy that made the ad is getting death threats. That's the issue, not that it's an ad. Of course it's an ad. Okay, and then they say, oh, Alex didn't say it was an ad. I say it's an ad. See, this is the mental illness, how they get us to get distracted on little things that don't matter instead of the big New World Order coming down on us. Here's the video, and then the ad that's been banned from many networks. Here it is. I have a very important message for you, my friends. Censorship is increasing, not just in this country, but worldwide. You've heard about Obama's kill switch. You've heard about calls to start censoring the internet, and big telecoms are openly admitting that they may restrict what websites you can visit. The old dinosaur media and the corrupt government system are afraid of you getting real information. They can't engage in the open free market of ideas. They want to censor information. Now, I was the voice of a national TV ad because I believe in the information they're putting out, dealing with the death of the dollar, QE2 and 3, the rise of a new global digital currency being pushed by the IMF and World Bank. I came out and voiced the ad because I believed in what they were doing. NBC, Fox, ABC, and others refused to run the ad. DirecTV agreed, and after it had huge success and over 10 million views, they recently pulled it. The only networks carrying it are Dish Network and Time Warner. In America, an organization creates a free video breaking down what's happening in the major news headlines. Dollar devaluation. Even the Wall Street Journal admits that the end of the dollar is nigh because of what the Federal Reserve is doing, and they censor it. This is outrageous. If you want to see the censored ad that they're afraid of you seeing because they don't want you to see the full hour-long video that breaks it down, go to endofamericavideo.com. That's endofamericavideo.com and see the ad that leads you to the film that the establishment is so scared of they don't want you to see. Porter Stansberry, that put the information together, he's gotten threats, all sorts of things that are being done to him because the system does not want you to know what they're doing. The banksters know they're killing the dollar. They've always planned it. George Soros and the rest of these people are setting up the new system now. All Porter Stansberry is doing, all the End of America video is doing, is trying to warn the American people so we have a chance to protect ourselves and to respond to the people that have done this so they can restore our country, restore our republic. Endofamericavideo.com, the video they don't want you to see.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years, but here's the thing. He's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet. And it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can watch it for free right now by going to endofamericavideo.com. Again, that's endofamericavideo.com.
Now, think about that. Here in America, they put it on some of the networks and then pull it because of pressure. And then the government spammers, and that's clearly what most of them are, then some useful idiots follow along with it, sit there spamming 24 hours a day, the same people, that, well, this video's on YouTube. It's not banned. I just said where it was banned. I just said where they wouldn't air it. They're preying on complete ignorance. Then they go, well, what was banned? The TV ad or the video? Which one's he saying? The point is the ad pushing into the video's banned. They just prey on the dumbest people. But these dumbed-down idiots don't even matter, folks, because they can't even tie their shoelaces. They can't even wipe their own noses. They can't even zip up their own pants. It's up to us that can think and have any critical thinking to try to wake up these zombies. But if we can't, move on to others. The issue is the system doesn't want to talk about dollar devaluation. They didn't like it during the 2008 campaign when Ron Paul was bringing it up. They don't want to discuss this information. Why? They don't want you to know about it. They don't want you to understand that they've announced a world government and a new global currency they're trying to push. And George Soros is having a big meeting next week pushing it. They don't want this discussed. That's why they're attacking. You can find the article that has the video at Infowars.com. Just search the term censored TV ad banned from airwaves. Censored TV ad banned from airwaves. If you want to find out more and watch the video that you just heard that points out what's happening. John in Wisconsin, you're on the air. Thanks for holding.
Hey, Alex, it's great to be with you.
Do me a favor, turn your radio off because I want to be able to hear you.
Hold on 1 second. Okay, number of things I'd like to say, and you got to cut me off when you have to.
That's fine, go ahead.
But anyway, you are second to none when it comes to getting the word out. I don't know what's being discussed. I listen to your radio program as often as I can, but it seems to me that there is no other solution than to follow one of our founding documents, which is the Declaration of Independence. We need to institute new government. These tyrants that are running our government in Congress and in the White House are not going...
We're trying to do that through the states, and there's big moves. Texas, Alaska, a whole bunch of other states are moving to ban the TSA and the state borders. Then their bosses will stage terror attacks so their mafia can roll in and take over. We'll expose that. I mean, look, the Sons of Liberty for 15 years tried to fix things peacefully before the feds came of that day, the British government, to confiscate the guns. That's when it began. But, I mean, how do we institute new government?
Well, again, it's almost as if we got to be careful what we say and be politically correct. But what did our founding fathers do? Where would we be if our fathers...
Well, when the British came to confiscate guns, they fought back. And, I mean, I don't think Americans should turn... They start mass gun confiscation. It's illegal. It's unconstitutional. It's tyrannical. We have a right to defend ourselves. But, right. I mean, that isn't going on. They're trying to slowly pass laws to do it. We've got to fight back. We've got right on our sides. The globalists have to stage terror attacks to then blame it on us to take our liberties. They want things to get violent because then they can start shutting the media down with their internet kill switch.
Correct. Yeah, and I agree with that, and I appreciate your time. A couple other things real quick.
Well, John, let me just comment on this big subject you raised. We've got to first reach out to the military and police. The number one donors to Ron Paul in the last campaign were the military. The military's full of great people. Just an evil system runs it. The average cop, I mean, I don't deserve it. I get pulled over maybe once a year speeding all over Texas. They almost always let me go. They're listeners. They probably shouldn't do that. You know, the point is that the average cop's good, the average military's good, the average government, the average corporate person's good. It's the globalists. Rothkopf, 3 years ago, wrote the best-selling book, Superclass, the head of the Kissinger Group. We had him on the show. You know, called up his publisher, got him on. He admitted world government. He admitted 6,000 people run the world. It's undemocratic. It's anti-freedom. I'm tired of them. They use government as their tool to control us. It's time to cut back the government. And if we're going to cut unions and things, first let's cut the bankers. First let's go after the Federal Reserve. Let's go after the 1.5 quadrillion. We got to get rid of that fraudulent debt we don't owe, or all these other cuts won't do anything. I'm out of time, John. I'm out of time. I'm sorry to James, Elliot, Kevin, Brooke, Richard, Francis. Call me back tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central. We'll keep those names. You'll go to the front of the line. First-time callers. We'll do it again tomorrow. We'll do first-time callers tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central, 12 noon Eastern. Great job of the crew. Look, we know history. We know what tyranny is. Let's wake up to it. Stand up and say we're free human beings. We're not your slaves. Get off my back. Leave me alone. Infowars.com.